following program is from NET, the Public Television Network.
To my nest, and it's going to take me an awfully long time because I have to carry them one sack at a time. Oh.
Hi, Pickford.
Oh, hi, Mr. Hooper.
What are you doing with these sacks?
Oh, I've got all these sacks of birdseed, and I have to take them all back to my nest. But it's going to take me so long because I can only carry them one bag at a time, and that's the only way I can do it.
Ooh, I wouldn't be so sure of that there.
Really?
Might be an easier way.
Oh, what's that?
Well, why don't you get something to put the bags in, something to carry them in, so you can carry them all together.
Hey, that's really a good idea. I wish I had thought of that.
You did, just now.
Hey, that's right, I did. And you know what I'm going to do?
What?
I'm going to find a box to put all these bags in. I think I saw a box over in the vacant lot. I'm going to go right over there and get that box. Then I can put all the bags in the box and carry them home in one quick trip.
Good.
Oh, thanks so much, Mr. Hooper.
You're welcome.
Bye now.
Bye-bye, Big Bird.
Oh-do-do-do-do-do-do. Yep, I think I've got just the right box here. Just the right box. Oh-da-doo. And here's a bag of birdseed to go in the box. Put it right in the corner there. And here's another one. Yep. Beep-a-doop-boo. Oh, and all of these over here, too. Oh, yes. Oh-da-doo-doo. Doop-boo. That's half of them. Four bags are in there. There it is. The fifth bag. And there's only two more left. Just two. I'm glad I don't have to take all of these one by one to my nest. And one more to go. The last one. There. No, they're all in the box, and I can carry it to my nest. Oh! 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 That's something I never thought of. All the bags are in the box, but the box is too heavy for me to carry. What will I do? Oh, I know. I'll push it. I'll just get around over here, and I'll push it. Ooh, ooh, oh, oh.
Hi, Big Bird.
Oh, hi, Susan.
What's this?
Well, I have all these bags of birdseed to take to my nest.
Uh-huh.
But I was going to take them one at a time, but it would take too long. So Mr. Hooper said, put them in a box.
Uh-huh.
But then I couldn't pick the box up, and I can't even push it. I've been trying to push it.
Why, it's too heavy.
Oh, I just can't push it.
Gee, I don't know. How are you going to get it to your nest?
Well, I don't know. It's
a... Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
What?
Let's see if we can use this. Maybe we can figure out something you can do with this jump rope.
Okay.
Tracy must have left it over there when she was playing. Let's see. Let's try this.
What are you doing?
Put it right here on this hook on the front of the box.
Hey.
Yeah. Try this, Big Bird.
Hey, let's see. Wow.
Oh, hey, that's going to work.
Look at that.
That's good.
It's even easier to pull it than it is to push it.
Yeah.
Wow, what a neat idea, Susan. Thank you.
Okay, just promise one thing, though.
What's that?
Bring Tracy's rope back.
Oh, sure, I'll do that.
Okay, see you later.
Thanks again, Susan.
You're welcome.
Ooh. Ooh. Well, it's easier to pull it than it is to push, but it's still not very easy. Gee.
Oh, hi there, Big Bird.
Hey, hi, Bob.
What's new on old Sesame Street, Big Bird?
Oh, well, I'm taking all this bird seed over to my nest.
Oh, wow, you got a lot of it here.
I sure do. You know, when I first started out carrying it over, I was carrying one at a time.
Mm-hmm.
But Mr. Hooper said, put them all in a box. You can save some time that way.
That's a good idea.
But then I couldn't even pick up the old box. What? So Susan said, why don't you pull it with this jump rope?
Hey, that's a good idea, Big
Bird.
Yeah,
but pulling is not that easy either.
You know, Big Bird, I think I've got an idea that would make your job even easier.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
What's
mm-hmm.
that?
Well, I'm not going to tell you what it is yet. You try and guess. But before you can count to 10, I will be back with what you need. All right?
Okay.
Okay.
Wow.
I'll be right back.
Okay, Bob. Gee, he's going to come back before I can count to 10. I guess I'd better start counting then. Hey, Bob, can I look now?
No, not yet, Big Bird.
Okay.
Not quite finished. I want this to be a surprise. Okay. Take a look now, Big Bird.
Okay. Hey! Wheels!
Yeah.
You put wheels on it!
Right.
It's not even a box anymore. It's a wagon!
Sure. How do you like it, Big Bird?
Hey, I really like that. That's great.
Let's put all the bird seed back in the wagon now, and then we'll give it a try. See if it's easier, okay?
Okay, let's do that.
Put this one in here. Boy, these are heavy.
Oh,
Big Bird.
That's right. I've been lifting these all day long.
There. I don't know how you carried all these, Big Bird.
Well, I'm a very strong bird, you know.
Okay, now I'll give you the rope.
Okay.
Now give it a try and see if that isn't easier.
Okay, here I go. Hey!
How do you like that?
That's really easy.
Isn't that much easier?
Yeah. Thanks a lot, Bob.
Don't mention it, Big Bird.
Yeah, just think of it. This morning, I was carrying these bags one by one. And then I put them all in the box, and I couldn't pick up the box, and it was too hard to push. So we put a rope on it, and then I pulled it. And that was easier. But now, with the wheels on the box and making it into a wagon, that's the easiest of all. Wow, what a day! Whee! Hey, I guess I'm going to go back to my nest now with all my bird seed. Bye, Bob. Thanks
Goodbye,
a lot.
Oh, you're welcome. Take it easy, Big Bird. Don't go too fast now. Oh, no. Oh. You know, sometimes I wonder if anything will ever be easy for the Big Bird.
Okay, Robbie and Tracy and everybody at home, I want you to look at all these animals. We have some silly animals here because we have the wrong heads and tails on the wrong bodies. and we're going to figure out how to straighten them out here. Now, who can tell me, first of all, you can change either a head or a tail and put it on the right body. Tell me what to do, and I'll do it for you.
Oh, I think I have one.
Robbie? What?
I think that head goes this on head? To this body, yes.
This head goes on this body?
Yes.
Okay. All right, Tracy, where does this head go?
I think this head goes right to you.
This head?
Goes over here to the camera.
Goes over here. All right, now wait a minute now. We've got two vacant heads over here. All right, we have two heads without bodies. Now, can anybody tell me where either of these heads go? Tracy?
This head goes right here.
This head with this body?
Yes.
All right. Robbie? You see another one you want to move?
Yes, I think this head goes over to that one.
This head over here?
Yes.
Okay, we'll put this head right there. Okay. Now what happens? Tracy?
I think this head goes right here.
This head with this body. And we only have one body left without a head, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. All right, we're doing all right with the heads and the bodies. Now, let's straighten this one up a little bit. Now, let's get these tails straightened out here. Mm. Who sees a tail that needs to be moved to another body? Tracy.
This tail? Right here. Goes over here.
Goes on this body here. Well, we'll put it there and we'll see if we like that. All right, what about this tail?
Oh, I think that one goes on to that one.
This tail goes to this body, completing this animal. And what is this animal, Robbie? This animal becomes what? Tracy?
An anteater.
An anteater, right. What happens to that tail then? Tracy?
This tail belongs over here.
This tail goes with this body here? We'll put it there and we'll see if we like that. What about this tail?
Over there onto the horse.
Oh, okay. Yeah, he looks funny with no tail, doesn't he? There, we'll fix him up. Uh-oh, horsey. Be careful here. All right, now we have a horse. Okay, who sees another move? Don't all speak at once. Can't stand the noise. Who sees another tail that goes with another body? Is this tail correct on this body here?
Yes.
Okay, and that becomes what?
A cat.
It's a cat of a sort, but it's a big cat. It's
tiger?
No, tigers have stripes. It's a lioness. A lioness. That means it's a lion, a female, a lady lion. The man of the species, or the male lion, has all that hair around his face. This is a lion, okay. And the anteater's fine, and the horse is fine. Now, are these tails all correct for these animals?
No, I think this one goes up there.
You think this tail goes with this animal?
Yeah.
Does that look right to you, Robbie? All right, I'll tell you, this tail does go with this animal. And what is this animal, Rob?
Elephant.
All right, the elephant's okay. But let's look at these other two. Do they have the right tails? Tracy, you think
yes.
They're right? Robbie, you think they're right?
I don't really know.
You're not sure? Okay, I'll tell you. No, this is the camel's tail here, I hope. And this is the giraffe's tail. Yeah. Okay, now that's the way they are. All right, let's name them all.
Horse.
Lioness. Camel. Giraffe. Anteater.
Elephant.
Okay, now let's notice something. Each animal does have a tail, right?
Yes.
But each tail is very, very different.
Now there's the tail for you. A nice short little tail. And here is one very, very hungry piglet. Look at him go at that, will you, Tracy and Lily? Whoa, come on back here.
Getting all over him.
It's getting all over him, right. get it right in front here now. There you go.
He's mighty greedy.
Well, that's why people sometimes say, don't eat like a pig, right? This little baby's only about 2.5 weeks old. And he drinks out of a bottle just like a little baby, right? Look at him go on that bottle. That Sesame Street milk is the best milk in the whole world, isn't it? See his little short, stubby nose? That they use that for sort of digging up the ground. They root for things to eat. Come on back here, little piggy. He's got a nice little short tail. You know, it's funny, animals use their tails all different kinds of ways, don't they? Can you think of some way that an animal uses the tail, Tracy?
Some animals, like little beavers, they use their tails to they use the back of their tails to dig up dirt.
To dig up dirt, and monkeys use theirs, don't they, Lily?
Yes.
To swing by. Hey, who knows what letter the word animal begins with?
A.
Begins with A, right? Animal begins with A.
Hey! 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 Hey!
Cheryl, do you know what the letter A looks like?
Yeah.
You do? All right. I'm gonna bring out something. You tell me what it is. What's that?
A.
It is. Which one?
Yes, more.
All right. Now another one. This
capital.
One. Oh, you're fast. That is the capital A. So we have what?
Small A and capital A.
We sure do. We got the A's.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Watch the bees go in their hive. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Here they all come out again. One, two, three, four, five. What I'd better do is dive. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. I'll never mess with bees again.
Hey, Lily, where do eggs come from?
Chickens.
From chickens. Where, but what about the milk? Where does milk come from?
From cows.
From cows. Now, what animal gives carrots?
An animal doesn't give carrots.
Where do carrots come from then?
A seed.
A seed. What animal do tomatoes come from?
It doesn't come from an animal.
Where do tomatoes come from then?
From a seed.
From a seed. Oh, that's good. Well, in other words, carrots and tomatoes are vegetables, and they grow sort of like flowers or a tree or something like that, right? It's time to play Three of These Things Belong Together. Look here on the counter and see if you can find the three things that do belong together. not counting me. Okay. Three of these things belong together. Three of these things are kind of the same. But one of these things, it doesn't belong here. Now it's time to play our game. Time to play our game. Okay, look. Dee 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 dee. Can you guess which thing just doesn't belong? Dee 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 dee. By the time I finish my song, I'm gonna finish my song. Take a good look, 'cause one of these things just doesn't belong here. Tell me, did you guess which one? If you guessed that this thing doesn't belong here, you're right. And now my song is done. Okay, let's look at each one. We have a knife. We have the alarm clock, fork, and a spoon. Now, we said that the alarm clock did not belong with the other three, because what do we use this for? We use this to tell what time Sesame Street's coming on, right? And we use a knife, fork, and spoon to eat with. Okay, let's play another one quicker. Let's look at the board over here. Three of these things belong together. Three of these things are kind of the same. But one of these things just doesn't belong here. Now it's time to play a game. It's time to play a game. Dee 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 dee. Can you guess which thing just doesn't belong? Dee 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 dee. Okay, take a look at everything now. One of these things just doesn't belong here. Tell me, did you guess which one? If you guess that this thing doesn't belong here, you're right. And now my song is done. Okay, let's look at everything. We said the skillet does not belong with the other three. Now let's discover why not. We have a head of lettuce. We have the skillet, we have a tomato, and a carrot. Now, these three things belong together because they're vegetables. They're something to eat for a nice salad or to eat for vegetables. And the skillet is something to cook with. You wouldn't take a big bite out of the skillet, would you? No.
I'll bet you have a hard time guessing what kind of animal this is today. I'll tell you one thing. I'm wearing some leather gloves because these are all very, very, very sharp, spiny little things on the outside of this animal. And every time I touch him, he sort of jumps to protect himself. This is called a hedgehog. A hedgehog. You ever heard of a hedgehog, Tracy? Now, you don't find many of them around here. They come mostly from places very far away, but you know, we were talking earlier about how animals have all the things they need to protect themselves. Well, this animal really has what he needs, because there isn't any animal that would like to attack this little hedgehog, because all of these sharp, spiny quills that come out of his body are very, very sharp, and even a poisonous snake, he can defend himself even against a big poisonous snake. Do you know that, Robbie?
No.
No? He's going to take a little walk down Sesame Street, I think. The old hedgehog. Kind of unusual animal, isn't it? Hey, listen, now that you know all about the letters A and H and T and numbers 10 and you got your knives and forks and spoons all straightened out with Susan, why, well, we have to leave. Time to say goodbye, but we're always here, so you drop in and see us anytime, okay? Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters A, H, and T.
And by the number 10. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.